May we pray? Almighty God, we thank you.
We dedicate this ship to America as a reforged link in a strong and necessary chain of defense, deep. We ask now for your particular blessings upon our president and upon the leadership of our Navy, Marine Corps, and country. May we all continue to work for the creation of a new...
And he put forward a program to do this austerely and at the lowest level of budgetary expenditure in the last 20 years as a percentage of GNP. And the naysayers, of course, were there to witness the confounding of the president's critics. Today, our president is witness to the fruits of his steadfastness and his courage. This great ship, it will be the latest technology and most modern ship in anyone's Navy in the entire world. The second principle of President...
Secretary Lehman, I thank you. Captain Fogarty, the officers and members of the defense, Weinberger would be here, but with all of us here, he felt that someone had to stay in Washington and mind the store. Navy blue and gold. I had a strange feeling that I'm back on the set.
We're fulfilling our pledge to rebuild America's military capabilities. In March, agriculture and economic coordination, our state is in the field. In contrast, America's strength is the bedrock of the free world's security. The freedom we love is not just our own. But over the past years, we began to give dangerous away from 1,006 to 453. Potential adversaries saw this new level of disarmament and the lack of will necessary to protect our way of life. Free societies such as ours where different viewpoints are permitted, there will be people who oppose the extension at any time, at any level. There are others, and I'm concerned about cost cutting, but they're dead wrong. Waste is government spending at any time, is a tool for waste in our national defense. A dollar wasted is a dollar lost, and a crucial effort to build a safer future for our people. Secretary, we're spending a disproportionate share on the military. Let me say this is not true. The program our nation can afford. It meets the threat, and it provides wages and benefits that are more akin to what our support for such key initiatives as the purchase of 2 aircraft carriers, the B-1 bomber, and the C-5 transport plane. As a nation, we are committed to take every step to substantially reduce the possibility of nuclear war while providing an unshakable deterrent. Our eyes to the fact that if the Soviet military power increased, so did their willingness to embark on military adventures. The scars are plainly evident in the number of third world countries, moves and ships. Freedom to use the seas in our nation's lifeline. For that reason, our Navy is designed to keep the sea lanes open worldwide. In support of amphibious operations, the New Jersey 16-inch guns can deliver shells as heavy as an automobile with midpoint accuracy and with ships afloat. History tells us that a delegate to the Continental Congress called the creation of our Navy the maddest idea in the world. Seems odd and a little ironic to me that some of the same critics who accuse us of chasing technology and gold-plating our weapon systems have failed. Most people remember the enemy as men and stranger and like how the enemy. Yet some have an image of a warlike man almost ready for a fight. Or let us remember him. He won the Nobel Peace Prize. And I will. Even the relationship between the B-14 ship and represents our determination to rebuild the strength of America's joint army.
Indian superior in command, if present, otherwise by message, for duty as commanding officer, USS New Jersey, Lando W. Zeck Jr., Vice Admiral, United States Navy, Chief of Naval Personnel.
On deck, section one.